What's up, man?
Yeehaw! No UFC talk. Ooh. Not that it wasn't a good weekend for UFC, but there were other sports that went on this weekend, and quite possibly one of the best football games at any level was played this weekend.
You have to be talking about the Auburn-Georgia game.
Yep.
That shit was ridiculous. I don't know if you people had a chance to see the Auburn-Georgia game, but it was, like, phenomenal. Like, George and I were going, we were like two little bitches just screaming, going, oh, are you seeing this? Are you seeing this? Are you seeing this? Like, because we kind of just threw the towel in on Georgia when Auburn was up by, like, 20 in the fourth quarter, and we were like, man, Auburn just looks better and better. And the next thing you know, Georgia puts three TDs on the board in probably about 8-9 minutes in the fourth quarter, and they're up with literally less than 2 minutes left in the game. And then you can kind of take it from there, Shorty.
Yeah, well, I mean, Auburn does the old Matt Stafford, the heave and hope. They heave it. the two Tyrones on Georgia on 4th and 18, on 4th and 18, instead of knocking the ball down, you know.
Could you say that? Can I get another 4th and 18?
Yeah, 4th and 18. So 4th and 18, bat the ball down. No, because one Tyrone wearing a Georgia jersey goes to pick it. I don't know why. The other Tyrone wearing the Georgia jersey reaches over his own Tyrone's shoulder, taps the ball, not down, tips it up. Well, that's going on. Chauncey Jackson for Auburn runs by the two Tyrones, and the next thing you know is the ball's being popped up in the air over his shoulder while the two Tyrones smashed into each other. Chauncey catches it and goes in and scores the game-winning touchdown.
Chauncey put on a lightning burner, Shorty. It was a wrap. I couldn't believe this just happened. Yeah.
And then Georgia gets the ball back with like a minute, and they drive down within striking distance. You think they end up having to throw a Hail Mary? No, all the kid for Georgia has to do is throw about a 30, 35-yard pass and got fucking buried.
And you know, the implications of that one play, seriously, what could be for a national championship. And that's no joke. I mean, the way shit's starting to run, you just don't know.
Not to cut you off, because that's what it does. It's not so much to put Auburn or Georgia. I mean, Auburn and Georgia got no shot at winning a national title with one loss. But I mean, what it does do is give Auburn the juice and the moxie and the confidence that to beat Alabama.
Right. Well, I mean, but you know, it's funny. Like, you see how much by Georgia losing, if Georgia had won, it would have mixed things up on the other side. But now, you know, you're looking at, okay, Auburn plays Alabama, okay? Now, they're on the same side, okay? If you're looking at right now in the BCS, George, Auburn's sitting at number 6, okay? Now, you've got a one-loss Oregon, okay? Mm-hmm. And ahead of them, you've got Florida and Ohio State and Florida State. Okay, now if one of those two teams screws up, and I'm going to tell you what, Baylor can go undefeated, but Baylor doesn't have a Big 12 championship. If one of those two teams screws up, and Auburn meets fucking Alabama, beats them, Alabama no longer goes to the SEC championship because they're on the same side as Auburn. Auburn, with one loss, goes to the SEC championship and wins it. There is a good probability with the computers that Auburn will be in the national championship.
Like I said, with that win that Auburn just pulled out over Georgia, it could possibly align them, if everything happens right, to put them in the national title game. Now, I don't understand why you didn't bring up, but next week, Auburn has off. And Alabama has to play at home versus a very powerful Chattanooga team.
Yeah, and Florida State has the same thing, too. They have, like, they basically have bye weeks.
Florida State's playing Idaho next week. Clemson's playing the Citadel. I mean, I think next week you got Texas A&M and LSU. That'll be a good one. Wisconsin at Minnesota. Arizona State at UCLA. And then Baylor's probably got the toughest game next week, and they have to go to Oklahoma State.
Is it Oklahoma State they go to?
Yeah, they're traveling to Oklahoma State. I'll say it one more time. They're traveling to Oklahoma State.
and who does Ohio? Ohio State plays
Indiana. This isn't basketball, so this is, they got no shot. I'm sure the spread's got to be up around 35. No, I'm not kidding. They should absolutely hammer the dog shit out of Indiana. Indiana's coming to Ohio State. And Urban Meyer's pissed off. He's like, the BCS isn't fair. Dude, suck it up. Hey, how do you think everyone felt when you were down in Florida? You didn't think it was unfair then.
Oh, it's a, and you know, I tell you a team right now that has looked good the entire season, and they're really probably kicking themselves in the ass, George, is Missouri. Because Missouri, you know, with that one loss they got, I mean, if they had not caught that loss and it, they just played a bad football game, it happened to be one bad game they played, they got that loss, it, they could be in a very good spot.
Well,
because on the other side, they would be either facing Alabama or Auburn, and they could be that team. Go
ahead. They're the only other team, in my opinion, who's got a challenge, and they have to travel to Ole Miss, which is, you know, anytime you face off a team, you get to see every single year, or they're going to start seeing every single year since they're both in the SEC now. It's going to be – this is not going to be a cakewalk for Missouri. If they think they're going to walk into Ole Miss and beat them handedly, I don't
No, because we saw what just happened this past. Well, that was Mississippi State, wasn't it?
Yeah,
with Alabama, they didn't just go right through them. It was a game, a decent game for Alabama,
20-7. I mean, put it this way: if this was week three, everyone would be wanting to know why Alabama is still number one. And no one's saying shit right this week, though.
Yeah, I mean, and you know, the thing is. You know, Urban Meyer can sit there and say the BCS, and that's why we're having a playoff system next year. But the bottom line is this, too. I mean, I'm somebody that's pulling to see Florida State go all the way. I like what they have down there, the program. It's like it's back to where it was, you know, in the mid and late 90s.
Yeah, they're back to raping people.
You said what now? Yeah. It's a typical Florida program.
They're raping people on the field. They're just killing them. They're just holding right. They're doing things against the other team's will, scoring lots of points. Just they're saying no, and they continue to pound through and say yes.
Wow. but seriously, they are all raping people on the field. but it's like I look at it, and you know, I mean, sometimes people could say, who do you think is the best team in the country? And, you know, Kirk Herbstreit was saying, I think Florida State's the best team in the country. And you know what? I think, hey, if Florida State plays Alabama and they get out to that typical lead, if they get a two-touchdown lead, I don't think Alabama can come back on Florida State.
I hope we get to see that. I hope we get to see the two best teams play this year, not the two best computer teams play this year.
Yeah.
For anyone who's followed the BCS over the last couple of years, you know the difference. The other game that I'd like to touch on is Stanford. Stanford went to USC and choked.
You know, ever since Kiffin got kicked off and the new guy took over the reins.
Have you seen this guy's last name?
What is it?
It's O-R. No, it's like Org. His last name, damn sight near, should be Oregon. So it's really weird when I see Oregoni. It's like O-R-G-E-R-O-N.
Right.
And then I looked at that, and it's like, somebody at Oregon wants to coach at USC, and I found out it's the guy's last name. I was like, oh, shit. Because Jack Del Rio, now stand-in head coach at the Denver Broncos.
And they know that he's obviously the USC athletic director. You know, Pat Hayden has contacted him and says, look, we want you here in USC. But I'm like, hey, man, this guy who took over is doing a pretty damn good job.
He's 5-1.
And they just beat Stanford. It's like, you know, this guy obviously has some type of rapport with his players. I mean, he's doing pretty well. Like
he's getting through. If he can get him to perform on the field, you almost have to believe that he can recruit him.
Yeah, and so, maybe that's why they want to bring Jack Del Rio in, because they know he'll be a strong recruiter and stuff. But the landscape of college football is going to change with this playoff system, man. I mean, I it's almost to the point where if I was USC, I'm like, hey, let's give this other guy a chance, because now we just have to focus on the Pac 12 or 10 or whatever the fuck you want to call it. If we can get out of this winning this, then we're guaranteed a playoff spot more than likely.
The only thing you lack with this guy is having Jack Del Rio, who's played in the NFL and coached in the NFL, walking into your son's house as opposed to Mr. Oregonian walking in, and you're like, cool, you went 5-2 last year, but are you going to get my kid into the NFL? What do you know about the NFL?
And you couldn't have said it better, because basically if that guy walks in and he introduces himself, I know right now if he walked in the front door of my crib and he introduced himself, I'd be like, who in the fuck are you?
Exactly.
Who the fuck are you?
And to recruit in that state, you're going to need name power at that head coaching spot.
Right.
I mean, because you're going to have to compete with Oregon and Cal and the schools in Texas, and you're going to have to compete with a lot of big name schools who are poaching these kids left and right. And like you said, with the playoff system, the SEC is not the only school that's going to get the system that's going to get hurt. Some of these other big name schools who are used to just walking in there going, we're from USC, and the kid busting a nut. Now the kid's like, I don't care, because I'll go over there and start, and we still got a shot.
Yeah, I mean, it is. It's getting competitive. I just cannot wait. I can honestly say this. I love college football. I know you love college football, George, and I think once we get a taste of that playoff, I think you're going to see a lot of people. Like, I can honestly say this. It will be close between college and pro football for me.
I agree.
With the play, you know, I think, and I know if they go to an 8-team playoff, then I will like college is definitely as much, if not more, than pro. Because the kids are just so emotional and up and wrapped up in it, and the games are so fucking exciting.
And the other thing I would love to see them do while we're making changes about college football, can we get rid of the clock stopping at every first down?
Yeah, that's why
it's hard for people to get behind college football, because the shit's a 4-hour ordeal.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That's
a
little ridiculous.
And I think some of the things they gotta make it a better transition into pros. I mean, 2 feet in, you know, 2 feet in when you catch the fucking ball, you know, don't stop the clock for you know, to move the chains and stuff like that. Keep the game moving. You know what I mean?
And I tell you what, now, as much as I'd love to tell you that I'm gonna be watching college football next weekend, I'm not. I'm gonna be picking up my Xbox One and doing homework and playing video games. Because there's just not that many. I mean, I might. Well, if put it this way, if all the features of the Xbox One work the way they say they're going to work day one, then I'll be able to do a little snap-in joint and watch the LSU game while I play my video game.
There you go.
That'd be nice.
Now, 2 weeks from you know, a week from this coming up weekend, then you'll be fucking glued to the television because there's going to be some good fucking games.
But until then, I don't know about that.